we're going to go ahead and start on our slides, getting to the meaty stuff. This is what you're waiting for, I know. Now that we've gotten to know you a little bit, I get the first slide, and these come from questions primarily that come to our forum. Sylvia takes care of that. She goes through those and pops these up. Here's one that came through recently. The question came in, a patient with upper respiratory infection is prescribed penicillin. She returns 5 days later with pruritus of the scalp following ingestion of penicillin prescribed and taken correctly. Please explain whether to choose A or S for the seventh character on the adverse effect code. Would it always be an S for any code in the adverse effect column? So let's look at the answer here. I'm going to change screens. Repeating the question, she wants to know if we're going to choose an A or an S. But actually, it's not going to be either one. Let's look at this in a test question format. So we know that the patient is here for a subsequent visit for the adverse effect of the scalp. The prescription was given correctly, and it just so happens that now they're going to be allergic to penicillin. So our first code is for the pruritus, okay, and that is going to be L29.8, and then our second code is the adverse effect, the prescription taken correctly. That's very important. You know, the correct prescription was prescribed and it was taken correctly. So an A stands for the initial visit. The D stands for the subsequent visit. And the S stands for sequela or late effect. All right. So now what we've got here is, look at the ICD-10 table of drugs and chemicals, penicillin adverse effect, which is T36.0X5. The X is your placement, with the seventh digit being D for a subsequent encounter for the problem of the pruritus. Let's look at the code in detail. Adverse effect of penicillin subsequent encounter, and you can also call, that's abbreviated as PCN sometimes. And what this includes, your excludes, the appropriate seventh character for this is going to be D, subsequent encounter, because it's the second visit. It's not the initial time they came in for the pruritus, it's the second time. So we have our A, initial encounter, D, subsequent encounter, and we have S for the sequela. And this is not the first time our patient is being seen for the pruritus. It is actually a follow-up visit, the second time the patient's being seen for the pruritus that was caused by the penicillin reaction. Okay, and then S, the sequela. This isn't a sequela. This isn't a, it's not really a late effect. What we're having here is a subsequent encounter for the pruritus. And why did they have the pruritus? They have the pruritus because of the reaction to the penicillin. So D is the correct answer. And just like we have in the test question, the answer would be B. First listed is why they're being seen, the pruritus. And then your T36, which tells us this is a reaction to the penicillin, and a 5, with D being the last character for this code. Very good. Okay, now going on to our next slide.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.